Okay. You usually use ramps to hide this shit, but...
Actually, I forgot you have the...
Okay. So if I try and have this go up, like... 75 degrees?
And I need to add an engine. Try driving it.
Okay.
Probably not gonna move. The wheels aren't big enough.
Okay. Wait, crap. Huh. Maybe this will work. The problem with working with no collision blocks, or low collision blocks, is they're really hard to work around. Okay,
Oh yeah, because they don't collide?
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm like trying to place collision blocks on other collision blocks, and it's just like, no! I was like, why?
Oh. I forgot steering. Crap. That'd be pretty important.
They should be able to attach.
Yeah, they do. It's just a matter of convincing them to do so. Oh, no.
The place right?
Alright.
Maybe. I can't see anything.
Well, you're on the, like, edge of the darkness. Get closer to the spotlight.
Yeah, I was gonna move. I copy a spotlight over, but yeah, that'll be easier.
Yeah, it does look like a fly. Maybe I should do that. Yeah, I should put some wings on this.
Oh goodness, that is not connected right whatsoever.
I need steering, though.
Here, Durf, you want to see my solution? I'm actually kind of proud of it.
What'd you do with the... Oh, what?
Get to the back of the neck.
Oh.
Yeah. Like, it's not perfect, but...
Oh, I see what you're
doing. I don't have these, like, really awkward holes and shit. Which is my biggest issue.
Well, why? Oh, because you want it to hinge right there.
Yeah, because otherwise, like, I'm going to have to make room or stuff and it would just look awkward.
I mean, like, you could move the bearing up one block and it could still open, but...
Yeah.
Then the top jaw would move forward a little bit and...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like this.
Yeah, it's good. It's, Uh-oh.
That's good. I'm just messing with angles at this point.
Oh, okay. I thought it was stuck.
Well, I mean, does your jaw open up a full 90 degrees? I hope not. That's scary shit. Oh, dude, you know what I could do? Now that... Oh, my God. Oh man, alright, hold on. Do I have this thing symmetrical? No, I don't. I gotta fix this. I gotta fix this fast. Oh yeah, I got my nightmare machine raring to go. Actually, you know what?
Alright.
I lost my controller. I'm gonna make this thing open sideways.
Oh god.
I'm actually gonna leave this nose on. looks like a mosquito.
Maybe? I don't know. I kinda wanna have it so it opens sideways, but I realize that probably would take, like, more effort. I'll think about it. Let's see. Did you say you were gonna add a no collision block at some point, or is that, like, too hard?
All blocks have to have some kind of collision if they're, if they, like, wanna actually...
Oh yeah, because it would be impossible. Okay, yay.
Yeah. Though I am gonna add, like, you know how the suspension can go through stuff?
Yeah.
The floor?
Yeah.
I'm gonna add a mod part like that, but it doesn't compress or have suspension glitches.
That'd be nice.
So it has, like, that usefulness without any of the messy glitches.
Okay, definitely need larger wheels. Alright. Bigger. Four by two or five by two?
Oh, yep. Yeah. That's good.
I don't think that's big enough.
Could I have? No. Yeah, my one problem is no matter what, I end up with a hole in the back of the neck, which I was kind of hoping I could avoid, but it looks like it's,
necessary?
Yeah. Well, that sucks.
What if you made, like, a flap on the back? So it's, like, on the outside on the back.
Oh, you know what? Yeah, you're right. If I do that...
So it doesn't really matter how much it opens. You won't see through it.
Yeah. Oh. All right, yeah. Don't worry about it. I have solutions.
You do?
Yes. No judgy.
Got to prabble?
I am just going to have
for a solution.
See Wander for expert solution.
Okay.
Expert spelled wrong. Solution is just like...
Slush.
Yeah, it's like slush, but like with some ooze and an umlaut, and you're like, has like a picture of like Fabio instead. Somebody like far more attractive than I.
That's how marketing is done.
Yes.
Ah, yes. Fabio.
Fabio. Just like everything about it is wrong, including the like original like me trying to like what is it? I guess infringe upon his imagery. This is stupid.
Think.
Monster dental care is hard.
Turning the wrong way, and I don't have enough. Okay. Okay. Need another.
Try this.
I don't need a light.
No, don't do that. Don't do that. That is bad.
Oh god.
It keeps folding backwards. I'm trying to animate this weird.
Oh no.
God, that is so... I'm just like tripping balls right now because I was thinking about the Saw movies earlier today, right? Like, you know that one where there's the machine or the contraption that like pulls your jaw open?
Yeah. Oh.
Man,
yeah.
Like, your bill just...
Yeah,
I don't turning even know why that. I was thinking of that earlier today, and now,
oh my
now
God.
I see this, and...
No, please, no.
Never actually watched a whole lot of the Saw movies. They never appealed to me. As in, I don't know, I guess I just don't
I didn't find them good.
I heard
that the first one was pretty groundbreaking, but then the rest just crapped out.
I think part of it is you have to innovate your movie at some point, and I think they forgot that part.
Yeah,
yeah, they kind of just used the,
same gimmick for... I guess a lot of movies
seven
do that,
times.
Though. Yeah, are any of you guys going to go off and see the new, Resident Evil movie?
I don't know.
Maybe at some point.
What are we doing in game? So right now, we're doing kind of like monstrous builds because we're obviously nighttime. We're going to be playing sardines, trying to scope out the one person that is hiding in, I guess, these monstrous vehicles.
This is funny.
What's funny?
I need to put wings on it. I made a mosquito.
Get out of here, you bloodsucker. Nobody wants you. You're worse than lawyers.
Damn. Yeah. It's not much worse than lawyers. But yeah.
Let's
I have a really bad... Or I have a really low opinion of lawyers for the most part, because I grew up around a lot of them in California. So, like, all of the kids I knew on my block, the problem kids were always the ones with the lawyer parents.
Oh.
So, like, the guy that introduced me to D&D, both of his parents were lawyers, and he was raised by nannies.
Oh, no.
Yeah. The kid across the street, I think, had a, like, stay-at-home soccer mom type parent.
Okay.
Which normally would be fine, except for the fact that she didn't bother parenting?
Oh.
For the most part. She was very lazy about everything. So, like, she didn't really teach her kids to try in school. Instead, what she would do would, she would just do her kids' homework for them if it was too hard.
Really?
Oh, wow.
Yep. Yep. That was actually a really common thing to do in the area, which was, like, really bleak and kind of frustrating as a kid, because it would actually impact my grades, because everybody for one of the projects I was in Southern California. I know Batbeard, I don't know if you guys did this, but did you have to make like a styrofoam missions after the missions, like around Southern California and San
really
Francisco area?
Have to? I mean, we did.
Okay,
but
we
that
had
was
to.
Part of like a group session, so
it was like that was the thing to do when
it was hard to like go to the specific like craft store to get the bells and
Michael's just straight up sold like the whole thing. They had each and every one of them as like a styrofoam thing you could buy down where I lived, which was stupid. Kids would buy that, and then their parents would pretty much just do it for them. Which was just sad, because, you know, I actually made my own. And so everybody, I guess everybody in my grade's parents more or less did it for them. And I just remember being kind of upset with my own thing, and then getting, like, I think one of my first C's ever, because, because the teacher's like, why didn't you do this like the rest of everybody? I'm like,
that's terrible.
Because? But that, you know, I'd actually gone over to a friend's house, and the parent was just there painting their thing for them. And it's just like, oh.
I guess I just have to paint it.
Oh, goodness. Okay, here we go.
Yeah, you're right, Durf. I'll just do it this way.
Give it tiny wings.
Oh, if you're wait, I totally forgot what we were even talking about.
Oh, for making this thing.
Oh yeah, if you're gonna do it sideways, I think you're gonna.
Well, I gave up on the sideways. I'm just gonna have it be up and down. Yeah.
Okay.
I liked my old way, because it didn't do this like weird hinge out thing, but. There's no easier way to do this without just ruining shit.
I mean, you could, like, build a anatomically correct jaw bone and all that.
Well, the problem is normally with jaws, you would actually open down. I can't really do that, though, because then it's immediately just going to scrape on the bottom unless I had the whole thing lift up.
Yeah.
And then have the luxury of skin. Oh god, can you imagine trying to like do skin in this game? Freaky.
Oh no. Yeah, that works.
Oh,
That's not gonna be much colliding.
Okay. Yeah, I'll probably just have it open significantly less than it was earlier. Yeah, that's more than enough.
I might need some headlights. What are you making?
Me or Durf or Effie?
I'm going for kind of a like a beetle kind of look to it.
Uh-huh.
It's harder than a beetle.
It's more like a tick right now.
Well, I still have to do the body shaping and everything.
Yeah.
Like, it's nowhere near done. Like, this is going to take a bit.
Let's see. I'm going to put some lights on the front.
Where's the...
I was originally thinking of doing a spider, but unfortunately, I'd have to extend the body out, and I don't want to make it too big.
Yeah, that was kind of my problem. I didn't want to make it too big, so I kind of accidentally made a mosquito-looking thing.
I was also thinking about having these legs fold in somehow, but I'm not sure how I can facilitate that. I could probably have them rotate up and then in, I guess.
Oh, my antenna? Okay, that's cool. Someone just suggested to put some the headlights on the antenna.
That's a pretty good idea.
Huh.
Okay. That's high praise from Effie.
I guess this can actually... Nah, he's not even thinking about what you said. He's just like, generic answer. No brain powered. Not thinking about
Redbeard. I definitely heard it, but no, that's not a bad idea, having antenna on this thing with the lights on top. See, Wander, I am paying attention. Sort of.
The mild amounts of desperation in your voice. Huh.
Yes. Probably gonna cause a problem.
Okay.
We'll see.
Okay, so this is even.
Now I need a control.
How to get this thing to worm?
Oh, I just realized.
Maybe I don't. Maybe I make it worse.
Do I make it worse?
It's gonna bug me.
Do I make it? I make it worse.
Oh.
Yahoo make it worse. Answers. How do I make it worm? Make it worse. Best answer.
Yeah.
I like that. All right. Shit. Is that gonna work? It will. I just gotta. Okay, I gotta do it like this. It'd be really nice if there was, like, just a hinge block in this game.
There is.
I don't think so. Not in the way that at least I'm thinking. Describe your hinge block.
Well, there's a hinge bracket, and then there's a hinge. There's two hinge brackets that you can use.
Okay, so this
where?
Is safe,
nearby the pipes. Underneath the wheels and the pipes and everything.
Oh, underneath the... Oh, no.
The hinge bracket, and then there's a type 1 and type 2.
Oh. Yeah, you can mean build the ring. A hinge with that, but...
No, I mean...
You'd still need bearings and stuff. No, I don't think that's what Wander means.
Yeah, what I want is like a... effectively, it would be a one block that has a bearing more or less inside of it. Oh. And so... That, like, okay. one side would rotate. You know, you could fix it on and... I mean, it would effectively be... I can see how you could probably glitch that, but that would be... Ugh. Yeah, I don't want to do that.
That's, like, a bad idea. You could probably do it with glass blocks and, like, an invisible bearing or something to make it look like it, but...
I bet you could almost glitch weld it all together.
Sounds like a bad idea.
But yeah, I think it would end very, very poorly.
Come on. Okay, now I've got to do all the logic and everything for this thing. Yeah.
This is pretty great.
Your creation is?
Yeah. I'm just, like, I have a very limited field of view, but I'm still able to drive because now I can see the trees.
Oh, man. I know how we could do sardines. If you finish too early, you could always just go and hide if you have nothing better to do. And then as we finish our vehicles, we come and find you.
Yeah, I'm gonna just hide somewhere.
We're doing this with... hide and go shack rules.
Uh-huh.
So, okay. You gotta make a shrine to, Shaquille O'Neal.
okay. Oh, that's gonna be great.
So as one moves back, three moves forward.
Technically, no, you don't have to make a shrine to Shaquille O'Neal.
I love the literal hide and go shack.
Shit, there's no easy way to get this with all the... Well,
Let's see if this works first.
Yeah, this night mod looks fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Really cool.
Durf did a great job with it. It looks super slick.
It's a pretty good skybox, too.
Yeah.
It's very nice and satisfying.
I do hope to maybe give it a better picture.
Yeah.
Oh, sure, yeah. You can probably sharpen this up a little bit.
Detail, yeah.
Did you just do all of that, like, by hand?
No, it was just, some generic Starfield sort of generating thing.
Okay.
And then I also put a gradient.
If I remember right, I want to say, like, NASA images are not copyrighted. Don't quote me on it. I'd look it up first.
They aren't.
Oh yeah,
they're completely public domain.
I've used some of them for the moon mod.
Okay,
pretty awesome.
Yeah, if you wanted to just grab like a straight up NASA Starfield.
Yeah, the problem is they don't if you look straight up, you'll see there's a little bit of stretching. They have to be made for the texturing. It's like a sky dome, not a box. But like it has to be spherical.
Well, I mean if you send me the texture map and like what shit you want to put together, I could probably paint it together pretty easily.
Huh. Okay.
Or at least I could take a look at it and then be like, nope, not possible.
Beam's legit.
Oh my gosh. Might have to move this just a little bit. Oh, it's backwards.
So, Batbeard, what kind of... Oh, wait, no. Shit. That's a terrible question to ask you. Effie, what kind of cartoons did you watch as a kid?
Oh, goodness. Lots of Looney Tunes. I remember that.
Really?
Was always a big fan. I don't know. It's just...
You and Bird. I never had enough exposure. It just wasn't on.
Really?
Yeah. There was, like, Tweety Bird in the morning. And that shit loses its luster pretty quick. At least in my experience.
Yeah. Other than that, once I started getting to, I don't know, probably about 10 or so, I started watching more of stuff like Emergency ER and a couple of other things. Like,
oops, I lost my headphones for that. What was that?
Once I started to... you know, getting a little older. I think I was when I was like 10, when most kids are still watching cartoons and whatnot. I started watching stuff like CSI Miami and Emergency ER.
Really?
Some of those other shows.
Oh, yeah. Right. I always forget still... you're the baby, so shit's slightly different for you.
Huh?
Yeah.
Started watching the
I'm
other
like,
kids
wow.
Shows.
CSI Miami. Wow, what a kid's show.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I mean, that's something that I was already 20 when it came on.
Exactly.
Basically, I started watching crime dramas and other stuff like that.
Let's see. Can you put lights on a switch? Oh, you can. Cool.
He never got to see the good Power Rangers.
No, he didn't.
I did not like the Power Rangers. I'm sorry.
Like I said, you never got to see the good one.
What was your favorite Power Rangers movie, Durf?
God, I don't even know if I've seen the movies.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the whole thing kind of... I mean... Yeah. It died out pretty quick for me.
I will admit, I kind of want to... I'm going to go see the new Power Rangers for sure. It just... it's probably going to be an experience full of regret. I reserve these...
I've heard the older stuff was a lot better.
I mean, it was bad, but we were also very young. So everything was, like, totally okay.
It's kind of like
yeah.
Star Trek. Like, the early Star Trek was really bad, but it's still really good.
Yeah. Unfortunately, they never, like, really ended it, because Sentai shows...
New Star Trek is just, like, really bad, but, like, really good in another way. Like, a totally other way.
Yeah,
like
it's
a Michael Bay kind of way.
Yeah, it's so weird how, like... going
exactly
from,
right.
Like, old Star Trek to new Star Trek, it's just, like... There is a completely different flavor change along the way here. I'm actually pretty okay with it. I really liked how the most recent one looked, even if it had the exact same plot as the previous one.
It's just like the Tron movies. Like, the original, it had a lot of substance to it.
Well, most of the original movies are always better than the old
ones. Now all the movies are all flash and no substance.
I don't know. Mad Max did a really good job. But I would say Mad Max is probably the notable exception.
I haven't actually seen it.
Oh, you haven't seen the new Mad Max? It's pretty good,
nope.
Actually. They did, I want to say, no CGI. Like, that was one of the things that they were going out of their way to do. And it kind of shows.
Wow.
Yeah, because It's really good.
Nice. I'll have to check that out.
So weird. So, even though my bearings are set up the same, one of them is traveling farther than the other. I don't know why. Huh. It's the front one here is traveling further than the other one on the other side. Even though they're identical.
You're on a hill.
Is that literally the only reason?
Yeah, I think the one suspension is compressed. Where are you going? Oh.
Moving it over to somewhere flatter just to see if...
Okay.
It's actually making that much of a difference. No, it's... Definitely still traveling farther.
They're colliding with your wheels, though. That's what I'm seeing.
Oh, here we go. Hang on. Colliding with wheels?
Yeah, that's what I see.
I see them colliding with the wheels. I just checked all the suspension. They were all on 9 now. So... And these are low collision blocks, too, so it's, it shouldn't be colliding.
Unless you didn't build your thing symmetrical.
No, it's... I'm pretty sure it's...
I can't even...
Yeah, let me move it over into the light.
No, I just couldn't climb it while I was more. Doing its thing. So it looks like... It's able to pass through the suspension on the right side, but not the left.
Yeah, Durf. Other thing.
Yes.
Could you possibly move the
six on each
the
side.
Invisible bearing down near the invisible wheel? That always messes me up, being like, where the shit is the invisible bearing? And I have to go to the very beginning.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because it used to be the micro bearing, now it's just invisible.
Yeah.
So we wanted to keep all the bearings together.
I guess that makes sense.
Bearing.
Oh, I know.
Then all
the
suspensions. Then all the seats. Yeah. It's kind of like the same order of the vanilla parts. You get the bearings first, then the suspensions. The seats.
Yeah, that's a good point. Okay.
But you also bring up a pretty good point, because I wanted to add in some more invisible stuff. So, like, people could have entirely invisible builds.
Yeah, every time we do like you weren't there for Scrap Bandidos, I think, right?
One of them?
Yeah, okay. Cause for Scrap Bandidos, for my train or whatever, I wanted to just do a totally invisible car that people had to like try and take out, which would be hilariously
so evil.
Annoying.
Wait, would we see the dwarf?
Yeah, the dwarf would be like the only visible thing.
Just like the Wonder Woman jet.
Well, actually, no. Now that I'm thinking about it, my original idea was that I was going to have, like a smaller car, but it would be like on top of the whole thing, so you just have this like flying car just scoot by. But trying to make an entire vehicle out of invisible bearings and wheels, kind of not worth the effort.
Yeah. I mean, that's going to be incredibly difficult to build.
Funny as shit, though. It is. Okay. You have to realize that is more than within the bounds of worth it for me. Just making this awful troll car.
No, it's still passing through where it should be. That is so weird. Hey! Bugs will be bugs. Uh,
engine.
I get it now. I know why it's turning farther.
You didn't build it symmetrical, did you?
No, it is symmetrical. I'm wondering if it's an issue with the way bearings rotate.
Why do you have
Well,
you have
they're
an
rotating
initial
in
angle
the same
set?
Direction. Because I'm just looking at how the controller rotates the bearings on 180 degrees on either side, and I'm wondering if that could be it.
Oh God.
What?
I opened up your controller.
Yeah, I know it's a mess because I have to I have it repeating.
You only need two.
Yeah, but then there's a long delay between them. I don't want
to delay. Hold on a second. I think I can do this.
Therefore, I programmed the entire thing because fuck it.
How goes the shack, Batbeard?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, I'm wondering if the entire reason why it's clipping in is just simply because of the way
I'm working on a few special things.
Because that's the only thing I can think of.
Why? Okay, wait. Can you stop this?
Kind of wide in the open though, but I don't care.
So this is the initial angle.
Where did I?
And then from there, it rotates 90 degrees in the opposite direction.
Right here. Okay.
And then it rotates 90 again.
So then this is why it's not going forward. Because you're already making this not go forward.
It's 35 degrees in each direction.
Yeah. Don't you want it 45?
Nope.
But you're going 90 and then 90.
Yep. Yeah.
Hold on.
Dude.
All four of these are set to 35 degrees.
Yeah, 235s is 70.
70 degrees.
Not 90. So like you're missing 20 degrees on one side just because
all of them are set to 35 degrees.
I know, but two of them are going forward and two of them are going backwards. Right?
Oh, it doesn't.
So for one side, you have to go 20 degrees more to reach the same angle.
How do I get it?
Trust me, just set all of your 90s to 70 and it will work.
Get it on that. Okay. It's gotta be a way.
Or you could just change your initial angles.
Oh, you know what? Here's how I do it. Take this, and then I need to place...
Here.
Did I just make a tooth with the mouth?
Here.
Fucking yeah.
I'm setting them back to 45 degrees, and you'll see it still does the same thing.
Okay. Yeah. Expert Effie in the house.
Well, here, come and take a look.
Gonna show us how it's done.
There, come here, take a look.
Yeah.
So go ahead and hit the button.
There
now.
We go.
Just set to 45 degrees.
But you can already see your left leg's inside the suspension now.
Yeah, but now go ahead and...
Okay. And?
Alright. Yep.
Come on.
Well, see, the reason I set it to 35 degrees is because I didn't want it to hit the suspension.
So no, I get that. I get that. That's
one more forward, or I guess it's not really
right,
that
I
big
need...
an issue.
Let's just do this. Grab another engine.
I get why you did that.
This?
It's just your 90 degrees is way too much.
Evidently.
Okay. This. To that.
Okay.
Oh, it doesn't fit.
Alright.
It doesn't fit.
Oh, that's done. I can start going for...
Huh.
Close to this, which is going to be...
Let's see, do I make it bigger? could make it bigger. Alright, let's make it bigger.
Okay. So, here's my question. Please work, please work, please work, please work, please work, please work. Thank you.
Trouble there, Wander?
No. It's no trouble.
Are you sure?
Uh-huh. I'm just trying to make a horror creature thing. Oh, shoot. I should have put this on its side. I'm a dumb. Maybe don't do that.
Doing it by like one rotation. There.
Right, need to make this really big now. Gonna look pretty square. So be it, right? And
bug splat.
Did I just bug splat all of you?
Yeah. Well, what did you do?
Nothing. I just duped a thing.
Nothing.
Okay. Well, whatever you did, it crashed us.
Yep.
Okay. Durf.
Yeah.
You wanna? I'll show you what I did.
Yeah, I'm trying to join.
Let's get it. Probably crash again.
Let's see if I can get in.
Yeah. Because I hope we don't have to do that all over again, because
No. It's still there. Server's still up.
Okay, good. yep. Round of applause for Mr. Wander here. Great job.
I mean, I didn't do anything special. I'll show you what I did.
Now the question is it because you duped vanilla blocks, or not vanilla blocks,
nope.
Spotted blocks, or is it?
Oh, okay. I can't even join.
What?
Apparently.
What?
If it gives you an error message,
try to not have a mod installed.
No, I mean it's just low collision blocks.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, like I said, if it gives you an error message, title connection failed, just retry and just load again. I've been getting it recently.
Yeah, I will absolutely show you what I did as soon as you get in. It's not super special.
Oh, now I can't even get in. A problem has caused your program to close.
It's funny, I started Scrap Mechanic again. Oh, here we go.
Yeah. Not
but
able to
it
join.
It wasn't connecting, yeah.
Yeah, I think,
give me a second. I'll get rid of my nightmare machine.
Okay.
Oh, God.
I just am going to save the completed version, and then we'll try the... Or
that's
then
it.
I'll cut
that's
all
interesting.
Of it off. Yeah, so
pick
what I did
everyone
was...
Everyone but the host.
Yeah, I just made a...
Oh, it crashed again.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Give me a second. I'm still working on deleting these.
Okay.
Turns out Scrap Mechanic does not like tentacles.
All right then. Yeah, that
would explain everything.
I'm just going to get the timeout error out of the way so that when I do try and join.
Okay. Deleting the tentacles very quickly. They were kind of adding lag anyway, so I guess it's fine. Maybe I'll make slightly less tentacular tentacles.
Yeah.
Although it is pretty amusing.
Okay, there we go. I think we're good. You can join now. And if you can't, I'll just summon a new world.
Oh, really hope it doesn't come to that, because I didn't get a chance to save it.
I mean, I can save your shit. I'm still fine.
That's true. Oh, bug
splash. Oh, wow. Still can't save, or I still can't.
Really?
Still can't join?
Yeah, nope. It's bug splatting.
Oh, dear. Okay, well, I guess I'll have a chance to rebuild my shack.
And Wanda's gonna get a chance to see what I've been doing.
I'll just close. I'll barely look at what you've made.
I might have driven off a little bit.
I assume it's the one with all the lights, probably.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Batbeard, did you?
No, I was working on rebuilding it. I mean, you know, from the existing, but I can start from scratch. That's not
okay. Right. Oh God, I just saw Durf. Holy shit! All right, that's pretty good. All right. I'm just gonna make a new world. Yeah. So I think I spawned a tentacle, and it spawned in a place that it shouldn't be.
Oh.
And that's what happened. Anyway.